Alright guys, this is a short video after a request from Scratch Armor to ask what render settings I use. As you can see, I use Sony Vegas for editing all my videos. I use that in conjunction with DxStory. I also use VoiceMeter with that as well, so that I can split all my audio tracks. So I have one track for in-game sounds, one track for my mic, and another track for other players on TeamSpeak. And I'll just open up a clip. So you can see that I've got three different tracks on this. It really helps for like montages and stuff if you need to take out any sort of talking or anything on top of it. The project properties I use, I always record at 1920x1080. I record at 30fps as well. I would love to record at 60fps, but any UTW players or Armor players will know if you get a map like Kavala or Tanoa, any of those kind of CPU intensive maps, 60fps is really hard to come by. So I just always record at 30fps. If you are using Sony Vegas, just everyone always remember, if you right click on your videos and go to switches, always disable resampling, because that will make your images look blurry during fast movement and stuff. It's just Sony Vegas trying to make the video smoother, I believe. If you've actually already cut your video up so you've got loads of splits and stuff on it, you can also press D to bring up this little box just to highlight everything. Just then go into edit up the top there and go to switches this way, and you can then do it for all your little ones that you've cut out. But for render set, I upscale all my videos, so as you've seen, I record at 1080p, but if I go into render settings here, I record on, I render on AVC, AAC. If you go down here, I've got a template that I've made up. As you can see here, the frame size is 3840x2160, so it's 4K settings. Apart from that, I think everything else is pretty much as standard. I've changed this over to the render using CUDA. I don't know if that makes any difference between using your GPU and your CPU, but that's just what I use just now. I've tried loads of different tweaks and things, like I'll change like certain settings just to try and make it look a bit better, but sometimes you get so involved in that stuff it's hard to notice the difference. But yeah, I'll just click through this so you can see what my settings are and all this. I don't know if this will be any help to anyone, but if you need any more information, I'll give you a little sample as well, a little picture here of just what it looks like once I've actually edited the video fully. It looks kind of like this. This is Miniclips Volume 2, so it just gives you an idea of what it looks like at the end, just before render. Anyway guys, as I said, any questions? I'm not sure if I covered everything that anyone wanted to see here, so if I missed anything that you want to know, just let me know. Thanks guys, goodbye.